Why does my hair look so dark today? And it looks like a big, like, one bouffant. There's, like, nothing happening. Is that Boehner? Is that Boehner?
Huh.
Okay, before we get started, can I just ask you guys to excuse my hair, my shirt, my left eyebrow? I think that's it for now. I am a mess. I am so busy this past week, cannot find time to film. It's 1:37 in the morning and I am filming a favorites video. This is normal in my world. So anyway, we're not here to talk about my busyness. I have a ton of favorites. I feel like I say that every month, but this month I feel like I have double what I usually have. So we're gonna have to try to breeze through everything. I'm trying not to be too loud because my kids are asleep. Let's talk about my favorites. Okay, let's start out with hair. So I have this Michael O'Rourke Rock Your Hair Bombshell Big Hair Powder. I've talked about this before if you've been here for a while. This is a texture powder. So you sprinkle it like on your scalp almost, like as close to your roots as you can get it. And then you just like zhuzh your hair. And this gives your hair a very dirty feel. It almost feels wet, like when you start to kind of rub it in. It's a very weird sensation. This works really, really well for short hair, or if you have long hair and you just want to get a lot of like volume at the roots. But this allows me to kind of just zhuzh my hair and make it do whatever I want without having to put a ton of hairspray in it. Bottom line is, if you have short hair, like if you have a pixie cut and you want that really messy texture, you need this. Any texture powder is going to work, but this one's from Walmart. It's like $8. It's not expensive and it works. I always go back to this one, so I love it as I swing it around violently. The next thing I have is the Moroccan, what is this called? Moroccan Oil Intense Hydrating Mask. I got this in my Generation Beauty swag bag and I was like, holy shit, this is huge. But it smells so good and I've been using this. Oh, it smells really good. I've been using it like once a week, maybe, if that, because my hair, with it being so short, I don't know, it just can go really greasy really fast. But I love this, like when my hair is feeling really dry and just damaged, I put this in, let it sit for like 10 minutes or an hour if I have time. I'll just like wrap my hair in a towel and just let this sit. And it works. It makes my hair so smooth, so silky. So I love this. And it says it's for medium to thick dry hair. I don't have medium to thick hair. My hair is kind of fine, but it works for me, so I like it. I have one perfume. I never talk about perfumes. I'm not one of those girls that has like a vanity full of pretty perfume bottles. I have like five. I just find scents that I like and I stick with them. This is my second favorite all-time perfume. This is my second favorite all-time perfume. My first is Givenchy Haute Couture, which is very hard to find. This is the Elizabeth and James Nirvana White. I have white and black. I like them together, or I like white by itself. I don't ever wear black by itself. This is just my everyday go-to. Like if I'm rushing out the door and I don't know what to put on, this is it. This just smells so good. It's like the perfect mix of sexy and like feminine. I don't know what the notes are. Maybe I'll pop them up for you guys. This is a very, very popular perfume. I feel like everybody loves this. It just smells so good on me. And every time I wear this, which is pretty much every day, I always have people tell me that I smell good. I wore this to Generation Beauty and I must have had 20 people tell me that I smelled good. Like, it just stays on me really well. So good. So, so, so good. Okay, I have one body care product, like shower product. This is the Soap and Glory Flake Away Body Scrub. Yeah, there we go. Ooh, it's late. Okay, so this, let me read you guys what it says. It's shea butter, sugar, and peach seed powder. It smells like heaven. I mean, like pure freaking heaven. I'm almost empty. This is probably my third one, second or third. This is the best body scrub you will ever use in your entire life. I always have people ask me online for good recommendations of body scrubs. like with self-tanning to kind of get the excess, like the old body self-tanner off so that you can kind of start fresh. I always recommend this. It's not too harsh, but it's not too gentle. It's like right in the middle. It smells good. It rinses away nicely. It makes your skin really soft. Soap and Glory is one of my favorite brands. I think you guys know this. This stuff, I'm telling you, I've tried so many body scrubs. This, hands down, by a freaking mile, beats anything ever. Oh, so good. Long old. So these are my Key Domino sunglasses. So I got these probably right at the beginning of October. I am so in love with these sunglasses. They're just very light. I love the way they look. I just think they're so cute. I love them so much. I've gotten really into sunglasses in the past like 6 months. I used to just wear Ray-Ban aviators nonstop. But once I discovered the brand Key, which I like to call it Quay, but it's actually pronounced Key. Once I discovered this brand, I was done. I ordered the My Girls, then I ordered the Koshas. I have a little bit of a Key obsession. These are amazing. I get my Key sunglasses from nyglass.com. They ship out in like a day. And they're just an amazing website. This is not sponsored. They have no idea who I am. But if you guys are looking for keys, New York Glass, NY Glass, you know what I mean. Okay, so let's start off with lip products. So I have one from Girlactic. This is the matte lip paint in Divine. I wore this in a video this month. This is like my go-to if I want to wear a liquid lipstick. This is like my go-to. I love Girlactic matte lip paints. Oh my god, this color, you guys, look at, oh, it picks up darker on camera. It's like this really soft, like, pinky brown. It's such a weird shade, but it's so good for every day. It's not too dark, it's not too light. So pretty. This is not what I have on right now. I am wearing Bashful, which is another one. I'll just show it to you guys while I have it in my hand. This is like a really good nude shade right there. Girlactic matte lip paints are so pigmented. They're not super drying. They're one of my all-time favorite formulations of liquid lipsticks. Really, really good. And then the other one I have is from Anastasia. This is Heather's. And this is the darkest, most sexual color. It's so sexy to me. It's like this really deep, almost like a blood red, like when your blood dries and it's that really dark, like brownish red. That's what this reminds me of. It looks so good on. I love this color, and I really, really like the formula of the Anastasia liquid lippies. Also really good. Okay, I have two primers to talk about. They're both very, very similar. I cannot decide which one I like better, so I'm gonna show them both to you. The first one is the Cover FX Illuminating Primer, and then I also have the Becca Backlight Priming Filter. I think that's, yeah, Backlight Priming Filter. These are pretty much the same product. Let me show you kind of the difference in how they look. I'll put a big blob of each one on. I can't decide which one is better, so maybe you guys can help me. I do feel like the Becca one, this is the Becca one. I think the Becca one is more like in your face illumination. See, I don't know, they're so similar. Now the Cover FX one is a little bit more liquidy in consistency. The Becca one's a little bit more like creamy. I hate that word. But they are both so good. If I'm going to wear a matte foundation like my L'Oreal Infallible or the Jouer Matte Moisture Tint, I like to use an illuminating primer. Even though I have oily skin, it just kind of, I don't know, it works well with a matte foundation. So I've been using these. I love both of them. I totally recommend both of them if you're looking for a good illuminating primer. These are both kick ass. Kick your ass. And now I need a tissue. Excuse me. Oh, that looks kind of funky on my hand. Okay. Okay, so this was the month of highlighters for me. I went totally balls on highlighters. The first one I've had in my collection for years and years. It was one of my very first highlighters, if not my first ever. Seriously, I know that's like a big deal, huh? I just realized that. This is Benefit What's Up. This has been in my collection, like I said, forever, and I kind of forgot about it. But I saw someone using it in a video, and they were like, it's so good, it makes your powder foundation like pop, and I can't remember who it was. But this is a cream primer, oh my god. This is a cream highlighter. Did I just say it makes your foundation pop? Can you guys tell it's like 2 in the morning? Okay, this is a cream highlight. So when you put this on, it looks like it gives you the same look as a powder highlighter. It's a cream, but it's not super wet. It just kind of like you tap it on and it just looks so pretty. Doesn't mess with powders. Like if you put powder on first and then go in with this, it doesn't do bad things. And I've been putting this on first, and then I've been going in with MAC's Oh Darling, which is from their holiday collection. Oh, that's what I have on today. It's like highlighter on heroin. Like, it is so intense and gorgeous and freaking, my life stops. When I put this highlighter on, my life just stops, and I sit here and I just like, are you kidding me? Like, look at that. It's so freaking good. This is one of the best gold highlighters that I've ever used since the day I got this. I have used other highlighters, I can't say that, but this has definitely hands down been my favorite. I am so addicted to this. You have no idea. I will be giving away possibly 2 to 3 of these. I'm gonna let you guys know for sure, but definitely will be giving away 2. So stay tuned. Okay, 2 other highlighters that I want to mention are from Ofra. I did haul these this month. These were in collaboration with the Dupe That Girls. If you guys don't know who Dupe That is, they have an awesome page where they kind of give you dupes of more expensive, like popular products. They'll give you like cheaper dupes. They're awesome. Their page is great. They're so sweet. I've met them numerous times. Very, very awesome, nice girls, and their page is so good. So I will link them down below, but these are the 2 highlighters that they created with Ofra. I feel like everybody is talking about these right now. They are really good. This is You Do You, and then this is You Glow Girl. They're both so pretty. Like, they're so soft. They're so pigmented. And I actually love both of them. I didn't think I was gonna love the more pink one because that's just not what I look for in a highlighter, but this on the skin doesn't look pink. It just looks very, like, I don't know how to describe it. It almost has like a whitish cast to it, but that makes it sound bad. It's so pretty on the skin. Next time I wear this, I will try to snap or like pop a picture up so that you guys can see it. These are both amazing quality. So impressed with them. Really great. I have one eyeshadow I want to mention. This is the ColourPop Shadow in Thirsty Girl. This is from their holiday set. I recently hauled this. I did swatches. I had it on my eye. This is one of the best eyeshadows that ColourPop has ever done. No joke. Like, I want to wear this every single day. It is so pigmented. It's just on the eye. This is so gorgeous. Like, I can't, when I swatch that, like, my inside's just like, it's just so pretty and it's so bright on the eye. Like, you get that like coppery brown, but you get the shimmer, which makes it like bright, and I just love bright, sexy eyeshadows. Am I even making sense? Look at that color. Like, that's all you need to see. Just look at that color. That's why I love it. And the name is Thirsty Girl. Hello, party of one. One mascara to mention. This is the L'Oreal Telescopic Carbon Black. Oh, I am in with this. I have had this for probably, oh, like 4 months. I probably should get a new one. But when I first got this, I didn't love it. I was like, it's kind of wet. It's not really doing anything. But once I let it dry out a little, look at that little tiny wand. That is so not my kind of wand. But once this dried out a little, this gives me so much separation, so much length. I have it on today. It's been the mascara that I've worn in every video since like 3 weeks ago. Like if you check the description box of my video, it's always this. I am so in love with this. It's drugstore, it's inexpensive. It is so good. Amazing mascara. I'm down, L'Oreal. I'm down with your plan. What? Okay, I have two blushes. They're both very similar. The first one is from NARS, and this is in the shade Madly, and I am in love with this. Deeply, madly, truly madly, deeply. Wasn't that a song? Yeah. This color is so pretty. It just looks so natural on the face. I don't have this on today. No, I have one of the new blushes from the new NARS Stephen Klein palette. We'll get into that in another video. But anyway, this is just so pretty on. Like, it's natural, but it still gives you color, but it's soft. It's like a really good everyday goes with everything blush. NARS blushes are one of my weaknesses. I mean, NARS in general is a weakness of mine. I mean, who am I kidding? Makeup is a weakness. Nail polish, clothes, shoes, purses. I love this. It's gorgeous. It's beautiful. If you need a new NARS blush and you don't have Madly, what are you doing? The other one is from Illamasqua, and this is in the shade, I can never get it open, Naked Rose. Look how pretty that is. This is so my kind of color. It's a really soft, almost like barely there pink. That's just what I love. I know some people would look at this and think that it wouldn't look good on my skin tone, but I like lighter blushes. And this, the formula is so good on it. Illamasqua powder products are really nice. I just love it. I love the way it looks on. Again, you can wear it with absolutely any eye look, any lip color. It's just good. It's freaking good. I love you, Illamasqua. And look at this little packaging. It's so... Why does my camera keep shutting? So ColourPop came out with liners this month, which you guys know I did a video on them. I swatched all of them for you. I will link it down below. I fell hard for the pencil liners. The pots, I don't care for. I can get the metallics to work, which I shouldn't say I don't care for them. I don't care for the non-metallic ones. They're just not my thing. But if you want more info on that, like I said, I'll put the video down below. I go way more in depth. But the pencils, phenomenal. Like, seriously good. They're $5. They last forever in my waterline. Forever. I mean for hours and hours. Like 6, 8, 10, 12 hours. No joke. They don't fade. They don't rub away. They're so pigmented. I mean, they're one of the greatest liners I've ever used. I know that's saying a lot, but they are really, really good. My two favorites are, what is this? Overboard. I've showed this one so many times this month, but it's like a coppery brown. Oh, it's so pretty. This is like my everyday shade. And then the one that I have on today, which is my other favorite, this is Piggy Bank. This one is like a, I mean, you can see it in my eye. It's like a magenta purple, this shade. It is so good. Like with dark purple shadow and then this in the waterline, I just love the contrast of like dark and light and bright. And these are probably my favorite thing of the month. Like ColourPop killed it with the pencils. I have every single one of them. I think every single one is phenomenal. Like, go get them. Like, just go get them all. They're $5. What? Why not? Right? I have a few brushes to talk about. Actually, I have four brushes. Holy shit. Okay, so the first one is from Morphe. I don't know what brush this is. I'm going to do some research and see if I can find it and pop it up on the screen, or I put it down below. I will put it down below. This is just like an angled kabuki brush, and I love this for foundation. It is so good for applying cream liquid foundation. Such a soft brush. It covers a lot of area. I just love the way it puts product on. Huge fan, like dying for this brush. The other one, also from Morphe, is the M527. This is from their new Flawless set. I just love this shape. I love that it's like a bronzer brush, but it's really thin. so you can kind of contour with it, and then you can just like blend it out. You can use it for blush, you can use it for powder. It's a very versatile brush. I love this. I use this almost every day for either bronzer or powder, so really great. This next one is gonna come as no surprise, the Anastasia A23 brush. I freaking love this brush. I get so excited to use this with my Oh Darling. It's like a match made in heaven. I just ordered two more of these. I feel like I've talked about this a lot this month, but this for highlight is just the perfect shape. It's super soft. It puts the product down, but it just puts it down beautifully. Like not too heavy, not too light. It just does it right. I am so, so in with this brush. Like, I want to sleep in bed with it. Oh, God, it's one of the best brushes ever. And then the last one is from NYX. Have you ever heard me talk about a NYX brush before? Isn't that, like, so random? This is the number 17 brush. This, for blending out shadow or putting, like, your crease shade in, your transition shade, this is such a good crease brush, like blending brush. It just blends. Look, I always have to do the motion. It just blends shadow so nicely. It's soft. It works. There are so many blending brushes that can be this exact shape and size, and they don't work. I don't know what it is, but this works. Like, it just does it, and it does it really well. So the NYX number 17, it's good. It's really good. Ooh, that was a weird voice. Okay, I have two nail products. So first, I want to mention Essie Penny Talk. I have used this nail polish in so many nail art, not tutorials, but just nail art manicures. I use this for so many different things. Like, I use it to do dots. I use it for splatter. I use it as a base. It's one of the greatest metallic polishes. Seriously, you need this. If you're into nail art, this goes with so many different colors, and the formula, it's so opaque, and it just, I don't know, there's something about it that makes it so easy to work with for nail art. Like, you can dot with this, like do dots, and then top coat it like 2 seconds later, it's dry, it doesn't smudge. Amazing nail polish. Oh my God. Settle down. And then I want to mention the Debra Lipman cuticle oil. That's just, it doesn't have a fancy name, just cuticle oil. This is expensive. This is a very pricey cuticle oil, and I know I probably shouldn't be recommending this because it is like $20, but when I got back into this like a month ago, I thought to myself, you have to put this to the test. Like, compare it to your other cuticle oils and make sure that it's worth mentioning because it's expensive. So I did that, and I am telling you, this works. Like, I put this on at night, and when I wake up, my cuticles just are gorgeous. Picture perfect. They're just like so smooth. There's no rough skin. Not that my other ones don't do that, but I feel like this one does it so much better. It smells really good. It has this really tiny little dropper, like it is so teeny tiny. I recommend this 1000%. I know $20 for cuticle oil is freaking insane, but if you're really into doing your nails and you're really having trouble with your cuticles, give this a shot just one time. I know you want to kill me. You're like, seriously, bitch, am I gonna go out and spend 20 bucks on cuticle oil? It works. Hands down, it works. Gorgeous. Cuticles, hands down, it works. What? Oh, I do have two quick unfavorites. This is so sad. Prepare. Okay, so I talked with you guys about these. Ugh, it hurts me. I was gonna say it hates me. It hurts me to have to mention these products. Let me give you a little bit of a backstory. It'll be quick. So one of my subscribers tweeted me. I think she tweeted me. I tried to find the tweet to talk with her, but I couldn't find it. She asked me, she was like, I have these same products and mine feel very gritty. Did I get bad ones? And I'm like, mine are great. Because I had been putting, it's a lip gloss, by the way. I had been putting them over top of lipstick and I didn't really notice anything. So after she said that, I kind of thought to myself, let me try them out on their own. And when I did, they're gritty as crap. Like, what is happening? These are the Dose of Color lip glosses. Dose of Colors. I always want to say color. These guys that I talked about in my haul, Rosé and Bellini. Like, what the French is happening? They are so pigmented. They are so gorgeous on the lip. Like, these colors to die for. But I have found they're gritty. Like, it feels like they have little sand particles in them. And I know it's not just mine because, like I said, someone tweeted me and said hers were like that. I don't know that I would have ever noticed it unless I wore them alone. When I put them over a lipstick, they're fine. But I can't wear them alone, and I want to because they're that pigmented. So this is sad. This is a sad day for me. I mean, I'm still gonna wear them. I think they're gorgeous. But why you gotta be gritty? I don't want no gritty gloss on my lips. No. But you're so pretty. I'll deal with it. Okay, so that is it for my October favorites. I know this is gonna be a long one. yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Oh my god, it's 2:30 in the morning. I'm gonna wash my makeup off and go to bed. Hopefully all of you are in bed having sweet dreams about lots of good makeup. I hope you guys had a really good October. I hope we have an amazing November. So I love you guys. Thank you again for watching. Thumbs up, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.
This is a gorgeous powder highlighter. It's a cream. Cash rolls everything around me. Cream, get the money. Dollar, dollar, million. Oh boy, oh boy. Oh boy. I like that it's kind of fat, but it's kind of thin. Ow. Oh my god. What? Don't do it, you're gonna poke an eye out. Bitch. I get so little. Not little. Oops, I'm gonna, oh, it's so expensive. Inexpensive. Oh my god, okay. Oh, shit. Almost choked. He looks like a serial killer. Like, seriously. Come on, Olivia, get him! Olivia Benson was taken hostage. What the fuck? I'm gonna try to find the name of this. Not the name, the number. It's a good day to have a good day. Okay, that was a lot. It just comes out of nowhere. Step. There's so many more things. Oh my god, it looks like I'm playing a piano. My hands are like, dun, 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 dun. It just, your body just melts off. Camel down. On the floor. Melted. Like a chocolate bar. In the sun. Oh my god, look at me all sexual with my black bra. I just like a black bra with a white shirt. You know what? I think it's kind of, ow, I think it's kind of scandy. And I like it. So.
She's okay with your side chick?
Oh, he got side chick.
I told her everything. I got down on my knees and I begged her to forgive me just one more time.
What?
She said she's gonna talk to us.
She's lying. The hell, I'm lying. She went right. She's right in that. Oh, oh my god, I popped. I need to have an asthma. Do you see? I can't talk. What is wrong with me? I need to have a breathing moment. I'm just gonna turn the camera off for a minute because I need to catch my breath. Like, I'm bold. One of them boys. I don't know.